Disinheritance of Spouse, Articles 921 to 923 of the New Civil Code. Under Article 921, there are 6 causes to disinherit a spouse, and 4 of these are also found in Article 919 and 920, which are the causes to disinherit a child in descendant and a parent or ascendant. One of these is common with Article 920, which are the causes to disinherit a parent or ascendant. Only one cause is new, meaning it's not found in Article 919 or 920. Article 921. The following shall be sufficient causes for disinheriting a spouse. Number 1. When the spouse has been convicted of an attempt against the life of the testator, his or her descendants or ascendants. This cause is common with Articles 919 and 920 and had been discussed under those articles. Number 2. When the spouse has accused the testator of a crime for which the law prescribes imprisonment of 6 years or more, and the accusation has been found to be false. Likewise, this cause is common with Articles 919 and 920 and had been discussed under those articles. Number 3. When the spouse, by fraud, violence, intimidation, or undue influence, caused the testator to make a will or to change one already made. Again, this cause is common with Articles 919 and 920 and had been discussed under those articles. Number 4. When the spouse has given cause for legal separation. This is the only cause which is not found under Articles 919 and 920. Legal separation is not a ground. If there is legal separation, you don't have to disinherit because disinheritance takes place by operation of law. But as long as there is cause for legal separation, the offended spouse can disinherit the offending spouse. Under Article 55 of the Family Code, the following are the causes or grounds for legal separation. 1. Repeated physical violence or grossly abusive conduct directed against the petitioner, a common child, or a child of the petitioner. 2. Physical violence or moral pressure to compel the petitioner to change religious or political affiliation. 3. Attempt of the respondent to corrupt or induce the petitioner, a common child, or a child of the petitioner to engage in prostitution or connivance in such corruption or inducement. 4. Final judgment sentencing the respondent to imprisonment of more than 6 years, even if pardoned. 5. Drug addiction or habitual alcoholism of the respondent. 6. Lesbianism or homosexuality of the respondent. 7. Contracting by the respondent of a subsequent bigamous marriage, whether in the Philippines or abroad. 8. Sexual infidelity or perversion. 9. Attempt by the respondent against the life of the petitioner. And 10. Abandonment of petitioner by a respondent without justifiable cause for more than 1 year. Number 5 cause to disinherit a spouse is when the spouse has given grounds for the loss of parental authority. Not all causes or grounds for the loss of parental authority are grounds to disinherit a spouse. However, the grounds enumerated under Articles 229, 230, 231, and 232 of the Family Code are grounds to disinherit a spouse. Said articles are herein reproduced for easy reference. And the last ground to disinherit a spouse is unjustifiable refusal to support the children or the other spouse. This paragraph is also found in Articles 919 and 920 and had been discussed thereunder. Article 922. A subsequent reconciliation between the offender and the offended person deprives the latter of the right to disinherit and renders ineffectual any disinheritance that may have been made. This article applies to the disinheritance of a child or descendant, parent or ascendant, or a spouse. What are the effects of reconciliation? If there is no will, it deprives the offended person of his right to disinherit the offending person. But if already disinherited, it sets aside the disinheritance already made. Article 923. The children and descendants of the person disinherited shall take his or her place and shall preserve the rights of compulsory heirs with respect to the legitimate. But the disinherited parent shall not have the usufruct or administration of the property which constitutes the legitimate. This article speaks of the representation in case of disinheritance. This means that the representative of the disinherited person will receive the legitimate which said disinherited person would have been entitled to. But will said representative also receive the disinherited heir's share in the free portion, if any? The answer will depend on whether the free portion had been disposed of in favor of other heirs. If the free portion had been disposed of in favor of other heirs, then the representative will receive only the legitimate which the disinherited would have been entitled to. But if the free portion is still intact, the representative of the disinherited person will receive both the legitimate and the free portion which might have accrued to the person disinherited if he had not been disinherited. The second part of Article 923 is self-explanatory. It says that the disinherited parent shall not have the usufruct or administration of the property which constitutes the legitimate. This is the end of this presentation. Thank you.